Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I am going to talk about the anatomy of the skull. The skull is viewed from different aspects. Norma frontalis from the front. This is anterior view of the skull. It's called the norma frontalis. Norma occipitalis, the view from the back, okay? To view the skull from the back. Norma occipitalis, and then norma verticalis, viewing the skull from above. And norma lateralis, viewing the skull from the side. Lateral view of the skull. And then norma basalis, viewing the skull from the base, from below. So norma frontalis, occipitalis, verticalis, lateralis, and basalis. Start by norma frontalis. Regarding norma frontalis, you should identify the bones, the sutures, the landmarks, and the foramina. Regarding the bones, okay, this is the first bone from above. This is the frontal bone, which is the upper part. This is the nasal bone, or nasal bones, one on each side. Okay. This is the zygomatic bone, one on each side. And this is the maxilla, forming the upper jaw. And this is the mandible. Regarding the frontal bone, it forms the roof of the orbit. This is the orbital plate. It has maxillary process and the zygomatic process. Regarding the zygomatic bone, it has frontal process and the maxillary process. Regarding the maxilla, it has frontal process, okay, articulating with the frontal bone, zygomatic process articulating with the zygomatic bone, and the alveolar process forming with the opposite one, the alveolar arch. So these are the bones. Regarding the sutures, this is the coronal suture between the frontal and the parietal bones. This is the metopic suture. Metopic suture is present in the infant skull between the two halves of the frontal bone. It disappears at the age of 2 to 6 years, and the lower part may persist in about 8% of adult skull. The persistence of the metopic suture may be mistaken for a fracture of the frontal bone. Then the frontozygomatic suture. This is the frontozygomatic suture. And this is the frontonasal suture. And this suture between the two nasal bones, the internasal suture. So we identified the bones. We identified the sutures. Now, the bony landmarks and the foramina. The bony landmarks. This is the first one. The frontal eminence. Of course, one on each side. And the frontal eminence is the site of center of ossification of the frontal bone. This is the second one. This ridge. This ridge is called the superciliary arch. Superciliary arch above the orbit. Between the two superciliary arches, this elevation is called the glabella. And the depression at the frontonasal suture is called nasion. And then the nasal septum, this is the nasal septum. And these are the nasal conchae, the middle and the inferior. Okay, middle nasal concha and inferior nasal concha. And then this eminence is the canine eminence formed by the root of the canine tooth. So we have landmarks, frontal eminence, site of ossification, superciliary arch, elevation above the orbit, glabella, elevation between the two superciliary arches, nasion depression at the frontonasal suture, okay, nasal septum, middle and inferior nasal conchae, and the canine eminence. Regarding the foramina, I see four foramina. This is the first one. This is the first one, supraorbital foramen. This supraorbital foramen or notch, it transmits the supraorbital nerve and vessels. This is the second one, infraorbital foramen. This infraorbital foramen transmits infraorbital nerve and vessels. This is the third one, this foramen, zygomaticofacial foramen. This zygomaticofacial foramen transmits zygomaticofacial nerve and vessels. And this foramen is the mental foramen. This mental foramen transmits mental nerve and vessels. So this is norma frontalis. Let us see this labeled diagram of norma frontalis. Regarding the bones, this is the frontal bone. This is the zygomatic bone. This is the maxilla nasal bones. Okay? Regarding the landmarks, this eminence is the frontal eminence. This arch, okay, is the superciliary arch. This is the supraorbital foramen. This is the frontozygomatic suture. This is the glabella. And this one is the nasion. This is the coronal suture. This is the zygomatic process of the frontal bone. And this is the frontal process of the zygomatic bone. This is the frontozygomatic suture. This is the zygomaticofacial foramen transmitting zygomaticofacial nerve and vessels. Infraorbital foramen transmitting infraorbital nerve and vessels. This is the mental foramen transmitting mental nerve and vessels. This is the canine eminence formed by the root of the canine tooth. Norma verticalis. This is norma verticalis externa from outside. Identify the bones, identify the sutures, and identify the bony landmarks. Regarding the bones, we have three bones here. This is the first one. This is the frontal bone, forming the anterior part. This is the occipital bone, forming the posterior part. And these two bones are the parietal bones, one on each side. Regarding the sutures, I see three sutures. This is the coronal suture. Coronal suture between the frontal and the parietal bones. This is the sagittal suture. Sagittal suture between the two parietal bones. And this is the lambdoid suture between the parietal and occipital bone. Regarding the bony landmarks, the first landmark is this area. This area is called the brigma. So brigma is the meeting of the sagittal and the coronal suture. This brigma in the newborn skull, it is the site of anterior fontanelle. This is anterior fontanelle, diamond shaped, okay, between the frontal and the parietal bones. Okay, so the brigma in the adult skull, anterior fontanelle in the newborn skull. This is the second one here. This is the lambda, and the lambda is the meeting of the sagittal and the lambdoid sutures. And the lambda is the site of posterior fontanelle in the newborn skull. And the posterior fontanelle is triangular in shape. The anterior fontanelle ossifies at the age of 18 months. The posterior fontanelle ossifies at the age of 6 months. So regarding the bones of norma verticalis externa, frontal anterior, occipital posterior, two parietal bones, one on each side. Regarding the sutures, coronal suture between the frontal and the parietal, sagittal suture between the two parietal bones, and the lambdoid suture between the parietal and the occipital. Regarding the landmarks, brigma, the meeting of the sagittal and the coronal suture, and it is the site of the anterior fontanelle in the newborn skull. This is the lambda, the meeting of the sagittal and the lambdoid suture, and it is the site of the posterior fontanelle in the newborn skull. We have this prominence. This is the parietal prominence. Okay, this is the parietal foramen or parietal emissary foramen. It transmits emissary vein between the superior sagittal sinus and the veins of the scalp. And this is the parietal eminence, which is the site of center of ossification of the parietal bones. This is norma verticalis interna. This is an internal view of the vault of the skull. Again, the bones, this is the frontal bone anterior, this is the occipital bone posterior, and these two are the frontal bones, one on each side. Regarding the sutures, this is the coronal suture between the frontal and the parietal. This is the sagittal suture between the two parietal bones. This is the lambdoid suture between the parietal and occipital bone. Regarding the bony landmarks from inside, okay, remember, this is the brigma. Yes, brigma, meeting of sagittal and the coronal suture. This is the lambda, meeting of the sagittal and the lambdoid suture. Okay, these grooves. Okay, this groove in the midline, this is the groove for superior sagittal sinus, extending from the frontal crest. This is the frontal crest. Okay, so this is the groove for superior sagittal sinus. And these grooves for the middle meningeal vessels. And these depressions, granular foveoli. Granular foveoli are made by the arachnoid granulations. So we have brigma, lambda, groove for superior sagittal sinus, grooves for the middle meningeal vessels, and the granular foveoli depressions made by arachnoid granulations. Okay, this is norma verticalis externa, and this is norma verticalis interna. The bones, frontal anterior, occipital posterior, parietal on each side, sutures, coronal suture, sagittal suture, lambdoid suture. The features, bony landmarks, brigma, lambda, parietal foramen, and the parietal eminence, site of ossification. Interna, this is the groove for superior sagittal sinus. This is the frontal crest, coronal suture, sagittal suture, lambdoid suture, and these grooves made by the middle meningeal vessels, and these depressions granular foveoli made by arachnoid granulations. Examination of the skull from the back. This is norma occipitalis. Okay, why to identify the bones, identify the sutures, and the bony landmarks. Regarding the bones, three main bones. On each side, parietal bones, right and left. And this one is the squamous part of the occipital bone. And this one is the mastoid process. Okay? So the bones of norma occipitalis, two parietal bones, squamous part of the occipital bone, and the mastoid process. Regarding the sutures, this is the sagittal suture, and this is the lambdoid suture. Okay? So sagittal suture, lambdoid suture. We have two more sutures. This one, occipitomastoid, and this one, parietomastoid suture. So occipitomastoid suture and the parietomastoid suture. Look at the occipitomastoid suture. There's a foramen here. This is the mastoid foramen. Mastoid foramen. Regarding the bony landmarks, of course, this is the brigma. Okay? Okay, external occipital protuberance projection. And the prominent point is called the inion. This is the medial crest, external, okay? External occipital crest. This is the brigma. This is the lambda. Lambda. Meeting of sagittal and the lambdoid suture. And this one, it's called the asterion. And this asterion is the meeting of three bones. The three bones are parietal, occipital, and the mastoid process. And this asterion is the site of posterolateral fontanelle in the newborn skull. It ossifies at the age of 3 months, and the clinical importance or neurosurgical importance, it overlies the sigmoid sinus. Asterion. I will go back to the asterion later on. Three nuchal lines. This is the superior nuchal line. This is the inferior nuchal line. And there is a small one here. It's called the highest nuchal line. So the three nuchal lines, highest, superior, and inferior. This is the mastoid notch or digastric notch, because it gives attachment to the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. This is the mastoid foramen. This mastoid foramen transmits artery and vein. The vein is a mystery vein between the sigmoid sinus and the occipital veins. And this artery is the meningeal branch of the occipital artery. So what are the structures passing through the mastoid foramen? Artery and vein. The artery is the meningeal branch of the occipital artery, and the vein is a mystery vein between the sigmoid sinus and the occipital veins. So this is norma occipitalis. Okay, again, this is norma occipitalis. Okay, let us identify the bones. Two parietal bones, squamous part of the occipital bone, and this is the mastoid process. Okay, this is the external occipital protuberance. This is the external occipital crest, superior nuchal line, inferior nuchal line, sagittal suture, lambdoid suture, occipitomastoid suture, parietomastoid suture. This area is the lambda, and this area is the asterion. This is the mastoid foramen. Okay. So this is the sagittal suture. This is the lambdoid suture. This is the occipitomastoid suture and the mastoid foramen. just reminding you, the mastoid foramen transmits artery and vein. The artery is the meningeal branch of the occipital artery. The vein is a mystery vein between the sigmoid sinus and occipital veins. Huh? This is the lambda. Okay? Meeting of sagittal and the lambdoid suture. This is the asterion. Asterion is meeting of three bones. Parietal, occipital, and the mastoid process. And this asterion is opposite the sigmoid sinus. And in the newborn skull, it is represented by the posterolateral fontanelle. It ossifies at the age of 3 months. The lambda is the site of posterior fontanelle, and it ossifies at the age of 6 months. This is the mastoid notch or digastric notch. This is the external occipital protuberance, external occipital crest, superior nuchal line, and inferior nuchal line. Okay? Then norma lateralis. This is norma lateralis, the lateral view of the skull. Identify the bones. Identify the sutures. Okay, the bones from above. From above. From anterior to posterior. Frontal bone. Parietal bone. Occipital bone. This is the zygomatic bone and the zygomatic arch. Zygomatic bone and the zygomatic arch. This one is the greater wing of sphenoid. This is the squamous part of the temporal bone. And this is the mastoid process. And this is the styloid process. And then bones of the face. Bones of the face, this is the nasal, this is the maxilla. And then if you remove the mandible, if you remove the ramus of the mandible, you will see the trigopalatine fossa, infratemporal fossa, and this fissure, trigomaxillary fissure. So you will see trigomaxillary fissure and infratemporal fossa, and they are deep to the ramus of the mandible. Regarding the sutures, this is the first suture. This is the coronal suture between the frontal and the parietal. This is the lambdoid suture between the parietal and the occipital. This is the squamosal suture. A squamosal suture between the parietal and the temporal bone. This is the occipitomastoid suture and the mastoid foramen. Okay. And then parietomastoid suture. This is the parietomastoid suture. And this is the frontozygomatic suture. So these are the bones and sutures of norma lateralis. Now let us talk about the landmarks. Talk about the bony landmarks. And then we'll talk about the structures attached to the styloid process, which are called the styloid apparatus. Regarding the bony landmarks, the first bony landmark is the pterion, this one, very important. Pterion is H-shaped suture. This H-shaped suture is formed by four bones. The four bones are frontal, parietal, temporal, and the greater wing of the sphenoid. So this is the pterion. The pterion is represented in the newborn skull by the anterolateral fontanelle. This is the anterolateral fontanelle. This anterolateral fontanelle ossifies at the age of 3 months. What is the clinical importance of the pterion? It's very important clinically for neurosurgery. The pterion overlies the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery. Therefore, fracture of the pterion might injure the middle meningeal artery, causing extradural hemorrhage or epidural hemorrhage. Again, the terion is H-shaped suture formed by four bones, frontal, parietal, temporal, and the greater ring of the sphenoid. This terion is represented in the newborn skull by the anterolateral fontanelle, which ossifies at the age of 3 months. Clinically, it is related to the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery, okay? And the fracture of the terion might injure the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery, causing epidural or extradural hemorrhage. So here, the second landmark, this one, is the asterion. This asterion is the meeting of three bones. Okay, meeting of three bones, parietal, occipital, and the mastoid process. This asterion is represented in the newborn skull by the posterolateral fontanelle. This posterolateral fontanelle ossifies at the age of 3 months also. And the asterion lies opposite the sigmoid sinus. So terion and asterion. Then superior temporal line and the inferior temporal line. The superior temporal line continues as supramastoid crest. This is the supramastoid crest, this one. Okay? External auditory meatus, this is the external auditory meatus. Above the external auditory meatus, there is a triangle, this one. It's called the suprameatal triangle. This suprameatal triangle is above the external auditory meatus, below the supramastoid crest, okay? And the surgical importance is that the suprameatal triangle forms the lateral wall of the mastoid antrum. It's very important clinically. Then the articular tubercle, mandibular fossa, and the head of the mandible. Okay, this is the TMG. Articular tubercle is very important to prevent dislocation of the head of the mandible. This is the mandibular fossa for articulation of the head of the mandible. Regarding the styloid apparatus, the styloid apparatus is formed by the styloid process and the five structures attached to the styloid process. The five structures are three muscles and two ligaments. The three muscles are stylohyoid muscle to the hyoid bone, styloglossus muscle to the tongue, and the stylopharyngeus muscle to the pharynx. It's very important to know that the three muscles are supplied by three different cranial nerves. The stylohyoid muscle is supplied by the facial nerve. The styloglossus muscle is supplied by the hypoglossal nerve. The stylopharyngeus muscle is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Why is that? Stylohyoid muscle is supplied by the facial nerve because it develops from the second pharyngeal arch. Styloglossus muscle is supplied by the hypoglossal nerve because it develops from the occipital myotomes. And the stylopharyngeus muscle is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve because it is derived from the third pharyngeal arch. The two ligaments, stylohyoid ligament and the stylomandibular ligament. So the five structures plus the styloid process form the styloid apparatus. Okay? This is a labeled diagram of norma lateralis, frontal bone, parietal bone, occipital bone. This is the zygomatic, greater wing of the sphenoid, squamous part of the temporal bone, mastoid process, styloid process, external auditory meatus. This is the mandibular fossa, This is the articular tubercle, zygomatic arch, zygomatic bone, nasal maxilla. The landmarks. This is the pterion, okay, site of anterolateral fontanel. This is the asterion, site of posterolateral fontanel. And the two ossify at the age of 3 months. Regarding the sutures, this is the coronal suture, lambdoid suture, squamosal suture, occipitomastoid suture, parietomastoid suture, and here is the mastoid foramen. This is the trigomaxillary fissure, and this is the infratemporal fossa. They are hidden by the ramus of the mandible. Fontanelles of the newborn skull. Four fontanelles. This is the first one. This is the anterior fontanelle. Anterior fontanelle between the frontal and the parietal bones in the adult skull. Okay, it is represented by the brigma. It ossifies at the age of 18 months. This is the posterior, it is diamond shaped. Okay. This is the posterior fontanelle. Posterior fontanelle between the parietal and occipital bones, represented by the lambda, and it ossifies at the age of 6 months. This is the anterolateral fontanelle. Anterolateral fontanelle between four bones, frontal, parietal, temporal, and the greater ring of the sphenoid, represented by the pterion, and it ossifies at the age of 3 months. And this is the asterion, posterolateral fontanelle, the posterolateral fontanelle between three bones, parietal, occipital, and the temporal. It is represented by the asterion in the adult skull, and it ossifies at the age of 3 months. So these are the four fontanelles: anterior, posterior, anterolateral, posterolateral in the adult skull, brigma, lambda, pterion, and asterion. Regarding norma basalis, or the base of the skull, it will be discussed in a coming video, okay? So wait for that video. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck. And see you very soon with a video on the base of the skull.